So the theme of the presentation today is about IT project visibility. So why the IT projects are getting challenged. So those of you who might have seen the Standish report, for instance, or any other research reports done, so generally they say about one-third to half the projects are successful, considering the cost, quality, and the time as the three main factors during the course of the project as the success parameters. But still, why so many projects are getting failed? So I have worked in numerous projects where while I was consulting for big consulting companies for Apple, for Shell, for Suncor Energy, those kind of companies, and even small and medium companies. So wherever I went, the story is the same. The IT projects are challenged. We have problems on requirements. We have problems in design. We have problems in testing, and overall jeopardizing the cost, the budget, and the timelines. So the based on the literature studies I have done, or my company has done, so there are three major areas where these issues have been pointed to. The first would be the varied value propositions of the stakeholders. So if you look at an IT project, for instance, say even if it is a 10-member team where you have a team lead, a project manager, a couple of developers, a tester, and an analyst, so there are many people outside the project who have significant influence on the outcome of this project. Like it could be somebody from the operations team to whom the project would be deployed to, and who has to maintain this application. So they might not be part of the project team per se, but they have a significant influence on how this project should be designed and run. So that could be one thing. It could be the sponsor who will not be there for the day-to-day affairs of for running the project, but still he has a significant interest, or he'll affect the course of this project. So and if you look at the developers, for instance, in the project, they might be looking at some of the technologies or some concepts which they can pretty much learn and put in their CV, so that the next project where they are getting might be an interesting one. So you can see that the varied value proposition, each one is in his own in his own world kind of things to understand and impacting the outcome of this project. Then if you can call it as an external factor, the internally the project itself has got its own challenges for these five main reasons. So it's not that the project is less complex or less challenging. The project itself is a complex animal. One of the things has been the fourth point which I have been giving in quite a few examples is about the visibility. Say if you take a construction project, for instance, I was consulting for a company called Air Liquide in France, and there the manager asked me, okay, so when do you think you can deliver this object? So I was in touch with a developer who was in India, who was in Bangalore in India, and he was ready with the design. He had tried out the code in the sandbox and everything, and he said that he's going to deliver it in 2 days. Whereas the manager there asked me, what's the status of this object? So I said, it's going to be delivered in 2 days. But he logged on to the development system, and he couldn't see a single line of code being written. So he was just mocking at me. So how do you think you can deliver in 2 days when not even a single line of code is delivered? Whereas in a construction project, this analogy might work. Whereas in an IT project, there's a lot of activities which happen in the brain or even in the even outside the system, which can't be tracked. So visibility, or invisibility for that matter, is an important thing when it comes to IT or the software projects. So that would be the second major challenge in IT projects. And finally, you have the lack of proven or practical measures, for instance. If you take the measures for complexity, the complexity is one which is a term which has been pretty much abused. The latest research on complexity comes up with 308 different measures of complexity. So if somebody had to pick a measure of complexity in the real world project, so which one he has to pick? So is it complexity means tough, or is it complexity means it has got so many ifs and ifs and buts in the whole flowchart, or does it have so many looping? So, or is it MECAP's complexity? So the different version of complexity itself shows that we don't have a proven list of practical measures which the people in the real world projects can use. These are the three major presentation, three major items which is affecting the project visibility. So coming to the problem, so okay, you have this key problem here. So what are you addressing here, and how does your presentation today address this problem? So the key problem here is how can we, our key issue here is how can we derive a generic and an objective measurement model taking into consideration the stakeholders' value proposition, which can help them in decision making and ultimately making the project successful. So this would be taking this as the problem statement. So the key research or key questions here is, okay, if this is the thing, now tell me how can you scientifically derive an objective and a generic measurement model, be it a COTS implementation or be it a customized project or if it is a custom development project or if it is a SaaS or if it is an on-premise. So given the so many variations of IT projects that are going on these days, how can you come up with a generic and an objective measurement model to meet which can be used to address the state, which can be used to know the project visibility, at the same time meet the value proposition of the stakeholders? Okay, so that's one part of it. Now you have a measurement model. Now the next thing is, how are you going to validate that? So is it being proven, or what are the measures in which you want to try this against? What are the criteria you want to say, okay, this has been tested against these scenarios before I start using it? So it's not just proposing the measurement model, it is also validating the measurement model. So these are the two research questions which are tied to this problem. So if you look at building the measurement model, there are three major areas in which we can look at the whole the whole exercise as, which is basically the theme of today's presentation. The first step is the measurement framework itself. So before you build the measurement model, what is the framework in which this model is going to be based? There are numerous measurement frameworks such as a balanced scorecard, GQM, practical software measurement, so many things. So which are the ones which we are going to base our measurement model on? Next, number two, once we have selected the measurement model, so what is the, how are we going to build the measurement model? So that would be the second phase. And finally, how are we going to validate this and implement this measurement model? So these are the three major areas which are going to be presented in the coming slides. So again, the measurement framework. From the measurement framework, we derive the measurement model. And once the measurement model has been derived, we are going to validate it both theoretically as well as empirically to show that this is a good measurement model. Is about identifying the measurement framework. Based on studies which we have done, so for an IT project, there are three major measurement frameworks which are applicable. One is the GQM, which is the goal question metric. The second one is the balanced scorecard, and third one is the practical software measurement. So these were the three.